Romance, yay.
Okay. Well, what did you do? Like, what was your contribution to?
Oh, I bought him. I got him a watch, and what else did I get him? Yeah, I got him a watch, and I got him a teddy bear and a balloon, and I got him a gift.
That's nice. Did he get you flowers and candy?
Yeah, he did. He got me flowers and candy. Okay. He did. Those were nice.
No gifts, okay. Though?
He got me flowers and candy.
Oh, okay.
You see, it was okay. It was cool. It was just not good. It wasn't even okay or cool. It was all bad.
It wasn't the worst.
I've been broken up with on Valentine's.
Wow.
Yeah.
I just probably think you wanted more from a guy that's not a boy. You know what I mean?
You're trying to show that, right? I don't know.
I don't know, though. But you said y'all a casual. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's mixing. Like, and I feel like you wanted the boy. Like, okay, there's a term in the sex. What do you call it? Sex worker life, where it's called the girlfriend experience.
Mm.
Okay? What that means is the hooker or the escort doesn't treat you like a hooker. They treat you like a girlfriend. You know what I mean?
The hooker don't treat you like a hooker.
Right.
You mean the John? What you talking about?
The hooker doesn't treat you like a John. My bad. The hooker doesn't treat you like a John. She treats you like...
Like she's your girlfriend. Oh, I see what you're saying.
That's what girlfriend experience means. Oh, and I feel like you kind of wanted a version of that. You wanted the boyfriend experience from a guy who's just... You know, he's not a John. But he's just somebody you casually dating.
No, I would honestly, Dino, I would have just been.
You wanted romance.
I would have just been happy with some thought.
A little bit more.
With some thought and with some effort. The fact that he came all the way to my house and he had no idea, no place of where we was gonna go to dinner, and he asked me to dinner, it just further showed me where I fall or where he wants me to fall in his life.
Well, if
you're not building with somebody, he's in his 30s, and if you're not trying to like go to the next level or really build with me, and you can't even show it, then it just kind of like,
I don't disagree that he could have shown more effort, but as far as the whole, I feel like guys should get a little bit of a break on the whole, because I've heard women complain about the guy not taking the lead with I know they've received the mixed messages, because I received the mixed messages too, and I'm older.
Mm-hmm.
And it was confusing for me out there dating, because we got this whole thing from the whole feminist movement about, you know, you guys not liking the fact that we, you know, take charge and we, you know, do, you know, make all the decisions and order for you and this and that, and y'all want to do this and that. And so it's like, but then a lot of the women don't feel that way.
I think that
it's kind of a mixed messaging, guys.
It's not that we don't. It's just, can we be included? Can I have a say-so in the inclusion? Can I have a say-so? And a part of it is not that I want to have all the control. It's just that I just want to feel like I'm involved too. And I don't feel like that's like a big thing. Like you, I'm pretty sure you would ask your wife like, hey, what do you want? When we want to go out to eat, what do you want?
Right, but I'm saying you can't do both. I can't include her and have it make a decision on where we're going at the same time. You know what I'm saying? It's either a we thing or a me thing. It can't be me and we.
No,
it's
but
one
you
or the other.
You can. I mean, you
no,
can
you
say
can't.
you can ask your partner like, hey, what do you want to eat? And she says Chinese food, and then you choose the Chinese restaurant.
Okay, so. Oh, so it wasn't enough back. So I don't get it. He didn't decide. He asked where you wanted to go.
He never asked me. He didn't ask. He did not ask.
Oh, he did.
He came and sat on my couch and was like, I didn't make a reservation. I don't know where we gonna go.
Oh, okay. Well, that's different then.
And I was like,
okay. Okay, that's different.
So what does that mean? And he was like, no, we gonna go somewhere. I got to figure it out.
Yeah. Okay. Well, yeah, that's different.
Yeah. So I'm just like, you asked me out like days ago, like almost a week ago.
It was pretty lackluster. No, yeah, that's what you mean. No effort. Okay, I feel you.
Okay,
I feel you.
Yeah,
I get you.
To this very minute, I'm still right here. Like, how did he do that?
I hear you.
How did he do that?
Okay, so before we move on, so we have to move on. We've been way behind. The question for next week, how about this?
Hmm.
Since this is Black History Month, it's almost over.
Right.
Put down any Black person that you feel is inspirational. It doesn't have to be a traditional person from Black history. It could be your mother, your father. It could be your neighbor. You don't even have to be Black. It could be a Black person that you know that's a friend. Just any Black person that you think a lot of and you would, you know, would like to
say that they're an exceptional Black person.
You want to give them some props.
Mm-hmm.
You want to shine a little light on them. This is somebody that you look up to and you respect. And, you know, you're happy that you know them.
I like that.
Okay.
That's cool.
All right. Cool. So that's the question for next week. All right. Now let's get into our mail and get on out of here.
Late like my Valentine date.
We late like Dijon. Okay, our voicemail comes from Lord Snooty.
Dino. What up, man? Hey, Red Rock, all that. You know what I'm saying? It's Snooty. Wanted to call and give y'all a little shout-out, man. I'm on actually listening to one of your episodes. I think one of the most recent episodes you dropped, you released. And I'm rolling, man. I'm laughing at this story about this air-conditioned vent y'all got going, stuff with all kind of riffraff, all kind of things in there. Danya. Man, listen. She playing you, dude. She playing you, son. Like, she hit you with the reverse psychology. Like, she fell on the sword. I mean, I know what you're saying because it was so long ago. With, you know, as far as the vent, putting stuff in the vent years ago, that's what it seems like. You investigated. You went through all the trash. You did all that type of stuff. I get that. Great. Your girl is good. Because when you came at her, before you could even come at her, she already hit you with the tears, the crocodile tears. She telling you how you need to take the tablet, all kind of stuff like that. Like, hey, I'm such a bad girl. Now you come to console her, you know, that type of stuff. She hits you with the reverse psychology. This is a good thing, though. This is a positive. I'm looking for the future. I'm looking towards the future. You know what I'm saying? Therapist, psychology, like, she could have a future in this field. I don't know in Cali how it is, if she can make a lot of money in that or not. But yeah, she good. She damn good. She playing you, dude. Go, Snooty out.
That's so funny.
Okay.
I never even thought about it like that.
But this is the thing, though. I hear him, and I agree with him, but that's not true. I just didn't go into the punishment phase.
Mm.
So she didn't get away with anything. Mm. She got punished, and she is still being punished.
Oh, okay.
So, just so you know. Nah, she don't, no. Nah,
she
nah.
went in there.
Dino don't fall for the okie doke.
Wait a minute. So when he was describing that, all I could think of was like them criminals, they go in there and they in front of the judge and they like, I'm guilty. I just throw myself on the mercy of the law. Do with me what you wish. Throw me under the jail. I don't deserve to live.
Like, pretty much.
Right.
That was pretty much it.
Yeah, well, so when he said that, all of that started rolling in my mind. Like, damn, it worked because I didn't even see it.
Yeah, no, it didn't work.
No, damn.
It didn't work.
That's crazy. That's hilarious. Yeah. She went and threw her cell phone to mercy of the court.
But yeah. All right. Thanks for the call, Lord Snooty. I love it.
As always, man.
Even though The Shiznit Show is not in Lord Snooty's top 12 favorite podcasts.
Oh.
Yeah, he did a post on Instagram, and he had listed his top favorite podcasts, and The Shiznit Show was not one of them. It's not in the top 12, even though there was at least one show in there that's not even having, they haven't done a show in like a year.
Mm. Damn.
Yeah, but that's okay.
But he sure do call in and show us lots of love.
He does. I can't imagine how he would treat us if we were in his top 12.
Man.
You know what I'm saying?
He might share the show.
You know what I'm saying?
Made me clutch my pearls, Lord Snooty.
That's right. Shout out to Candy Ladies and Ashtrays.
Shout out.
Ashtrays and Candy Ladies. I forget which way it goes.
Well, we love you anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
All right. With that, we out of here because we's late like
mail.
Oh.
Like a check that's in the mail.
Lay like Dijon's period.
No, God, please. if you ever answer the prayer.
So for Pip Lily, who is not here, for Dijon Monique,
just the girl in my world.
I'm Dino Red saying holla at your boy.
From all of our crew to listeners like you, thanks again for tuning in to another episode of The Shiznit. And don't forget to tell your friends about the show. Check out our website, theshiznitshow.com, or hit us up on Facebook under The Shiznit. Follow us on Twitter at The Shiznit Show. Write to us at theshiznitshow@gmail.com, or leave us a voicemail and make it sexy at 424-261-4878. This has been
The Shiznit.
You're listening to the Red Rock Podcast Network.